Ravan Sukha Prabhuji, can I get a smaller one, small table? That one. Wait a minute, I need a small table. Thank you.
You want some?
Yeah, the stand. And some water.
Yeah, water.
Thank you. Thank you. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Jai Shri Shri Radha Madan Man Bhagwan Ki, Jai Shri Shri Man Mahaprabhu Ki, Jai Shri Shri Lakshmi Narasingha Dev Bhagwan Ki. Okay, let's sing a bhajan. Everybody is ready? May I sit down? Anybody knows how to play mridanga? Okay. Damodar mridanga bhajan? Yes, slowly. This. Okay, we'll sing a new song today. So just cope up. It is a little slow song, but we'll try our best to go faster. You can repeat after me. Dhule dhule Gaura Chanda Hari Guna Gaya Re. 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 Asiya Brindabone Nache Gaura Rai. Asiya Brindabone Nache Gaura Rai. Dhule dhule Gaura Chanda Hari Guna Gaya Re. Dhule dhule Gaura Chanda Hari Guna Gaya Re. Go down. Can you go down? Who's? Brindavaner taru lata prema koe hari katha. Brindavaner taru lata prema koe hari katha. Nikunjer pakhi guli, nere pakhi guli, Hari Nam sonai, Hari Nam sonai. Dhule dhule Gaura Chanda Hari Guna Gaya Re. Dhule dhule Gaura Chanda Hari Guna Gaya Re. I think somebody is not doing good job there. Can you make sure someone is? You don't need to go to the first sentence again. People know that, okay? Go to number three, please. Gaura bole hari hari, sari bole hari hari. Gaura bole hari hari, sari bole hari hari. Mukhe mukhe suka sari, हरि नाम गाए रे मुखे मुखे सुका सारी हरि नाम गाए रे ढूले ढूले गोरा चांदा हरि गुण गाए रे ढूले ढूले गोरा चांदा हरि गुण गाए रे As said, Prabhuji, you don't need to go to the number one. That is just the repeat. Hari name matta hoye, Hari na asi che dei. Hari name matta hoye, Hari na asi che dei. Mayura mayuri preme, नाचिया खेलाए मयूर मयूरी प्रेमे नाचिया खेलाए ढूले ढूले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाय रे ढूले ढूले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाय रे प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि हरि बोलो बदन भोरी प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि हरि बोलो बदन भोरी हरि नाम गे गे रसे गले जाई हरि नाम गे घे रसे गले जाई ढूले ढूले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए रे ढूले ढूले गौरा चांद हरि गुण गाए रे आसिया जमुनार कूले नाचे हरि हरि बोले आसिया जमुनार कूले नाचे हरि हरि बोले जमुना उथले ऐसे चरण धोयाई जमुना उठले ऐसे चरण धोआई ढूले ढूले गोरा चंद हरि गुण गाए रे ढूले ढूले गोरा चंद हरि गुण गाए रे ढूले ढूले गौरा चंद हरि गुण गाए रे ढूले ढूले गौरा चंद हरि गुण गाए रे ढूले ढूले गौरा चंद हरि गुण गाए रे लेट्स रीड द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ दिस सॉन्ग गो डाउन ओके स्क्रॉल डाउन ओके द मून लाइक वी हैव सम मोर माइक्रोफोन ओके थैंक यू प्रभु जी लेट मी रीड वन एंड देन समबडी कैन रीड टू The moonlight Lord Gaurachanda arrives in Vrindavan while dancing, swaying to and fro, and singing the glories of Lord Hari. Can you read to Radhika? Yeah.
The creepers adorning the trees of the Vrindavans are overwhelmed with ecstatic love, and they are speaking about the glories of Lord Hari. Flocks with the birds who live in the groves are singing the name of Lord Hari.
Go next. Yeah.
Lord Gauranga says, Hari Hari. A female parrot responds, Hari Hari. And then all male and female parrots start singing aloud chorus of the name of Hari.
Becoming intoxicated by the holy name, the deer come forward from out of the forest. The peacocks and peahens are dancing and frolicking in ecstatic love.
Ecstatic love.
Arriving on the bank of Yamuna.
No, no, number five.
Oh, sorry. Lord Hari is in his heart. Lord Hari is in his meditation, and he always chants the name of Hari with his voice. Gaura Chanda is intoxicated by ecstatic mellows and rolls around on the ground while singing and singing Harinama.
Arriving on the bank of Yamuna River, he dances wildly while chanting Hari Hari. Mother Yamuna becomes so ecstatic that she rises and comes forward to wash Lord Gauranga's feet.
Very good. So this is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he is entering Vrindavan forest. This is the whole symptoms you can see. And this year, 2015, is very special. Why? Who can say why it is so special? Spiritual master? Purushottam must come every 3 years. That's okay. 2050, we are celebrating
50 years of Srila Prabhupada's arrival in US.
That's also very good. But this relating to the song which I am telling about, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's 500 years of reaching to Vrindavan Dham. Bolo Hari Bol! Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki! Jai! So this is the year is completing. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu struggled so hard and he came just few times, two or three times. We have been going many times, we are not getting Hari. He got Hari in the first time. Bol Gaur Hari! He is himself Hari, but he is also Gaur Hari. He is looking for black Hari. The gold Hari is looking for black Hari. But in between there is another golden girl who comes into picture. That's why the Sukha Bole Hari Hari, the Sari Bole Radhe Radhe. So they're fighting. So, but they joined together, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, don't change my mood, just both of sing Hari Hari. So they admitted to join the party of Chaitanya's. Hari Hari, Bolo Hari Hari!
Hari Hari!
Do you feel good?
Yes.
Yes. That's the magic of Gaura Hari. When he reached Vrindavan, how long it takes? Month and month. He started Sarat Purnima and he reached in Kartik Purnima in Vrindavan Dham. First he reached Mathura and from Mathura he went to Vrindavan. Because Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu discovered all the holy places in Vrindavan Dham. And then he gave it to all of us. That's why we are all fortunate, loyal, or thankful, grateful to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because of him, today is the Vrindavan Dham is manifested. It was there 5,000 years ago. But there was no spot of finding which is Radha Kund, which is Syam Kund, which is this Kund. All we are seeing was all excavated and re-established. The place was there, it was hidden. Just like a deer is searching for water. Water, water, water in the jungle. But on his feet, the whole pond is there, but it is just covered with a few layers of bushes. So he's not unable to see the water. So he's searching for that. Water, I'm not thirsty. My dear sir, just hoop around. You will see water there. Right, Nihar? Yeah. Have you seen deer? Have you seen deer? Yeah? How did he go for water? Have you seen deer drinking water in the near 280? No? You can try with your dad. All around. You see that how they are drinking water. Okay? Take your books and go, but don't distribute books to them. You can chant Hare Krishna. Okay? Give a big hand to Nihar. He has been doing very... Thank you for being here. So that is the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. So we are going to discuss today Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Prabhuji, open that chapter 4, text 28. Om Namo Bhagavate. Let's read the Mangalacharan. Have you opened Mangalacharan, Prabhuji? Or we can do the short cut. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya. Okay, so everybody can get it. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Jnananjana Salakaya Chaksura Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaham Sri Chaitanya Manovistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Sayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Sva Padantikam Bandeham Sri Guru Sri Uta Pada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamsa Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Rahunathanitam Tam Sajivam Sadvetam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakha Nitamsa He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopisha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Brinda Banesari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Vyasascha Kripa Sindhubhyo Evacha Patitanam Pavinebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesa Sunnivadi Paschatya Desa Tarine Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Mukham Karoti Bachalam Pangum Langheti Giri Yat Kripa Tamaham Bande Sri Guru Dinatarinam Ishvara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha Anadiradir Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam Hari Hi Om Hare Krishna. Repeat after me. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Bhagavad Gita, chapter 4, Transcendental Knowledge, text 28. Drabbayagya stapoyagya Yoga yagya stathapare Swadhyaya jnana yagyascha Yathaya samsita brataha One more time. Drabbya yagya stapo yagya Yoga yagya stathapare Swadhyaya jnana yagyascha Yataya samsita brataha
Word for word.
Drabbya yagyaha Sacrificing one's possessions.
Tapa yagyaha
Sacrifice in austerities.
Yoga yagyaha
Sacrifice in eightfold mysticism.
Tatha
thus
apare, others, sadhaya, sacrifice in the study of the Vedas, jnana yajna, sacrifice in advancement of transcendental knowledge, cha, also, yatayaha, enlightened persons, samsita brataha, taken to strict vows. Translation. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Having accepted strict vows, some become enlightened by sacrificing their possessions and others by performing severe austerities. By practicing the yoga of eightfold mysticism or by studying the Vedas to advance in transcendental knowledge. Purport. These sacrifices may be fitted into various divisions. There are persons who are sacrificing their possessions in the form of various kinds of charities. In India, the rich mercantile community or princely orders open various kinds of charitable institutions like Dharmasala, Annakshetra, Atithi Sala, Anathalaya, and Vidyapeeth. In other countries too, there are many hospitals, old age homes, and similar charitable foundations meant for distributing food, educations, and medical treatment free to the poor. All these charitable activities are called Drabya Maya Yajna. There are others who, for higher elevations in life or for promotions to higher planets within the universe, voluntarily accept many kinds of austerities such as Chandrayana and Chaturmasya. These processes entail severe vows for conducting life under certain rigid rules. For example, under the Chaturmasya vow, the candidate does not shave for 4 months during the year, July to October. He does not eat certain foods, does not eat twice in a day, or does not leave home. Such sacrifice of the comforts of life is called Tapomaya Yajna. There are still others who engage themselves in different kinds of mystic yogas, like the Patanjali system for merging into the existence of the Absolute, or Hatha Yoga or Ashtanga Yoga for particular perfections. And some travel to all these sanctified places of pilgrimage. All these practices are called Yoga Yajna. Sacrifice for a certain type of perfection in the material world. There are others who engage themselves in the studies of different Vedic literatures, especially the Upanishads and Vedanta Sutras or the Sankhya philosophy. All of these are called Swadhyaya Yajna or engagement in the sacrifice of studies. All these yogis are faithfully engaged in different types of sacrifice and are seeking a higher status of life, Krishna consciousness. However, is different from these because it is the direct service of the Supreme Lord. Krishna consciousness cannot be attained by any one of the above mentioned types of sacrifice, but can be attained only by the mercy of the Lord and His bona fide devotees. Therefore, Krishna consciousness is transcendental. Om Tat Sat. Who understood? Can anybody give one reflection? Just the translation. Microphone is there. Wants to share? Very simple. Just repeat what has been said. Radha Kripa Prabhu.
Hello. Hare Krishna Prabhu. Prabhu, what I understood from this purport is that various forms of austerities, you know, described, especially, you know, even if it is mentioned that it helps to advance in having a transcendental knowledge. But Prabhupada put clearly mentioned that, you know, we cannot attain, you know, Krishna consciousness because we, by performing such austerity, because it is only practically possible by mercy of Lord or the mercy of a pure devotee.
Very good. Thank you. Anybody else?
Hare Krishna. So just to add up, also it's very difficult in this age because it's really not easy to perform those kind of sacrifices which we used to do, like where which used to get performed in the previous yugas. So yeah, that is one thing.
Very good. Give the microphone, just wait. Give the microphone back.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. I am thinking that also to identify who is qualified, there are several other methods that were described about. Therefore, we are not intelligent enough or we don't have discrimination power to where to put the money, where what to do. Probably that's the reason. And Krishna consciousness says that they can only attain this by mercy of the devotees and bona fide devotees. And also I'm thinking we need bona fide guru also. Without that we can't even meet with the other devotees and learn. This is what I'm learning from the paragraph.
You're right. Very good. Thank you. So you got the essential conclusive part, which is very good. Please give a big hand to all. Very nice. Thank you, three of you. So similarly it has been there. So we have also bodies are layers, like we have Drabhyamaya, Annamaya, Pranamaya, Jnanamaya, Vijnanamaya. So we are covered. There are people who are addicted to food only. Have you seen? Morning, evening, breakfast, anytime you go, they will talk about, oh, I have to cook pasta, I have to buy this, I have to do this. Means completely absorbed with food. Right? There are some section. There are some level of people who are pranamaya. Pranamaya means, oh, I have to learn pranayama, Vedic techniques by this hatha yoga, this pranamaya. So they have been addicted to such kind of, which is positive to understand in order to neutralize their bad breath, neutralize their bad thoughts in the process of this pranayama. And then the next, there are people who are called Jnanamaya or Vijnanamaya, who is advancing in evaluating, analyzing, assessing the scriptures to understand what is right, what is wrong, what is truth, what is not truth, what is religion, what is not religion, what is to be accepted, what is not to be accepted, like yama and niyama. Do not. Because you have to know what is to be done, what is not to be done. Isn't it? Then we come to the later state, which is called the Atmamaya, Brahmabhuta stage, where people are self-realized. They're completely self-realized. They are not in the bodily concept of life. Their activities, their intentions, their objective, their mission of the life is to discharge only the Brahman complete spiritual, the concentrated spiritual activities for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord. So here, first of all, we have to unfold those things to know what is already there in our heart, a moral, an exemplary activities. For example, people say, oh, Bill Gates has given $39 million for eliminating AIDS in Africa, or $10 million to India for eliminating malaria, which is appealing, which is there in our heart as a great work, isn't it? That is true. This particular sloka is going to discuss about that what is there in your heart and how to develop the ideas of misgivings, those things as impermanent, as material, but on the other hand, not to criticize, not to detect mistakes, not to nullify their actions, but at the same time be in a positions that they are in the same path of transcendentalism, which might take a long time or which might not yield to the real success of life by which they should get the Supreme Lord. So first thing he talks about, go to the 428 Prabhuji, the Bhagavad Gita. Yeah. So first thing we talked about is little up, more, yes, yes, sloka, thank you. So drabhya yajna. So what is, we know that yajna is like sacrifice. Whenever people donate, is it not a sacrifice? Somebody asks you, okay, you donate to goodwill. You are basically giving you rejected stuff. Is it sacrifice? Practically not. Because you are not going to use it, you are going to trash it or something. So you are little good conditions, but it is not your belongings which you possess, which you'd like to possess. So it's not a sacrifice. But still you get the returns. You gave 5 pairs of your dresses, 5 toys from your kids, which he's not going to play, he already played enough, and something like that. It is not a sacrifice. Sacrifice is which is priyam. Which is priyam to me, and somebody asks is, and you are giving to it, or voluntarily you are giving to it. You got a new toy, you have not yet opened. The guy who come from in San Francisco, he was showing in ABC News. He just came out from this shopping complex. He had toys. The guy outside waiting that he donate new toys because they have to give to some unprivileged kids. So he just gave it there. He just bought for his kids. He just gave it there. That's the real sacrifice. Means sacrifice in terms which you possess something, which you wanted to have it, which you thought that you wanted to enjoy with it, which you know that this is mine, I am proud of it, I have it, and you have to give it to someone. That is the real sacrifice. So what has happened? So there are people who opens.
I need your keys. Okay.
Sorry, just a minute. Okay. So this is like Drabhya Maya, where Prabhupada mentioned in India people open dharmasala, ponds. My great grandfather has opened few ponds. In the villages, like 2 or 3, it like $1 million means money is really required to open a big pond. But after a few years, government takes all that. It's ours. You know, that was the civil laws, maybe when India got independence later on. So whatsoever it. But people invest. There was a concept of charities in every society. Some do it, some don't do it. But you are getting your results by performing those charitable works. So what is their things? Dharmasala, Atithisala, Annamaya, giving charities, etc. So how does it differentiate in ISKCON also? We do food for life. Have you heard about that? Food for life means we also distribute foods to the people, those who are unprivileged or those who are not getting sufficient meal, nutritious meals around the world. How does it happen? A very good example in Africa is not so advanced countries in terms of financially, they are rich is there. So we have in ISKCON distribute food, prasadam. So one day the thief came to one of the houses of this Hare Krishna. They wanted to steal. The burglary is there. So they wanted to steal from that houses. So when they entered there, they came. And they are about to pack up their stuffs, you know, whatever the important few stuffs, and they are going to take it. While going back, they saw the picture of Gornithai and the altar, the picture of Gornithai, Prabhupada, and this bus where it goes to distribute the food. Then they say, oh, these people give food to us. He's food for life, the Hare Krishna, these guys are Hare Krishnas, they give food to us, don't take. So they left all these things. But by the time the owner, he woke up at the same time and he was listening the last part of the conversation where they just left their home by keeping the stuffs which they packed to steal. The point which I wanted to make, this is the impressions they get. Drabhya Maya Because after many years, people will be only drabya maya. How I get food? Because you are generating so much of apple, so much of notepad, so much of tires, so much of many things. So there is nobody is investing time in producing food. In India, everybody wants to be IT, software, engineer, doctor, everybody, everything other than farmers, right? Those who cannot do anything, they become like farmers. So, Sidrabhya Maya is also at one point of time will be manifested, but those karma also we can engage in transcendental activities by offering those food to Krishna and distributing to the people in general. So what is happening? So in Africa there was the same region. In India we develop every temple, Delhi, in Bombay, in Bangalore, you can go to Calcutta, Mayapur, all the big temples in India, we have the provision to distribute prasadam, free prasadam. 200,000 plates we distribute in Delhi, Noida areas itself per day. Just the midday meal to the students. So this has been going. So people are getting positive transcendental devotions towards Lord because by engaging within the periphery of Krishna consciousness. But if you do independently out of Krishna, then you are getting your results, which is positive reactions from this particular work. The second stage is Tapo Yajna. Tapo Yajna, which Prabhupada mentions, is Chaturmas, which especially we did Kartik, it ends Chaturmas, the 4 months of strict vows of not eating urad dal, not eating spinach, not eating yogurt, not eating milk for a month. This is 4 months, and not only that, not shaving head, not traveling anywhere, completely chanting Krishna Katha, and many other things. We are here not able to do Chaturmas. Those at the time when Chaturmas comes, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was traveling in South India, Chaturmas comes, they said that you cannot travel, sannyasi stays one place. Wherever they are, they stay there. And they chant this Krishna, Hare Krishna mantra, or discuss about the Bhagavatam. There are not only this, fasting on Janmashtami, fasting on Ekadasi, and there are many other regulative principles which is developed in all religions, especially in Christianity, in Islam, in Buddhist, in Jainism, in all religion. This Tapo Yajna is there to certain stages. There is one person who was sowing in Nepal. They are trying to hit themselves with the chain. This kind of yajna they are saying. It's like a mode of ignorance. But one person is taking and just hitting himself and blood is coming out from his body. But they are like, they have to hit like 108 times or something like that. Because it is their Tapo Yajna. There are people, I have been there in Odisha in some places, which is tantrics. So they pierce, you know, sword from one side to the other side. No blood is there. And they pierce knife in the tongue. It will be there like this. And they will walk for 2 hours for worshipping the goddess Kali. So, but by seeing that, you will see that I am not doing nothing. So this guy at least doing such an empowered state. But there are many places in, even in Cuba, in Peru, in South America, there are a lot of mystical tantric set of things. So there are different sets of this Tapo Yajna is there, which people perform either to please in the mode of ignorance, to please the goddess Kali, or to Rajaguna, to please the demigods, or in the complete mode of goodness to please Vishnu. So either way, everybody has a tendency to do some tapa, isn't it? There are very lazy men in the world, but mostly people like to do some tapa, means, okay, I take a bath in the morning. We went to distribute Srimad Bhagavatam. Where is Nikul Prabhu? He's not, yes, Nikul Prabhu. So we went there and they said that we have not taken bath yet, so we won't take Bhagavatam. I said, we will wait for 1 hour, we'll come back. You call us, you take shower and all, you do your tapa. Because in the winter it is tapa for them. Okay? So we'll take bath and then we'll call. They said, okay. Then after 1 hour they called, we are ready now. We have taken shower, we are fresh, we are ready to worship. That's good. So we came, we did the installation ceremony of Srimad Bhagavatam. Please give a big hand to Ram, who was a very fortunate soul to receive this great knowledge. So that is, tapo is there. People have idea that by tapo only I am going to touch this Bhagavatam, isn't it? So there is an idea, but we are not performing it. Somebody has to enable their actions so that they can link to Krishna. So similarly, by taking the bath and doing the worship on that day, they get the pure mercy of Srimad Bhagavatam, isn't it? Even though it is 3 p.m., doesn't matter if somebody has not taken bath for 3 days, and after that 3 p.m., he has taken a bath and worshipping with incense and ghee lamp and flower to Srimad Bhagavatam, installing, donating money, that means their tapa, that particular bath for that day, is much more meaningful than what has been done in other area, other days. So that's why the tapo yajna would be there in all the societies and everywhere. People perform for obtaining something. Ravana did tapo or not? Ravana also did tapo. They have gone 10,000 years. Every 1,000 years, he is chopping one of his head. Every 1,000 years after sacrifice, is not satisfied, 9 head is gone. Then Lord has to appear and give him the benedictions. Brahma has to appear and give the benediction. So similarly, Hiranyakasipu is doing tapa, Kalanemi is doing tapa, Kansa is doing tapa, all the asuras have performed tapa to attain the mystic power. So don't think that somebody is rich that he has not put hard work. Hard work is put, everything is there, just to come to a position, to acquire some position. But now we'll talk about what is the end of that. So let's discuss about yoga yajna. Yoga yajna means, you know, Ashtanga yoga. Like people now, yoga yajna, the last portions of this yajna to samadhi, pratyahar, these are the things people are forgetting. Only thing is, only the asana, which is more manifest. But doesn't matter, but some form of yoga is there around the world. They are performing the yoga yajnas. And then, swadhyaya jnana yajnascha. Swadhyaya means, adhyaya means study. Swa means self-study. Have you studied some Vedic literature? Those who are seer, definitely Bhagavad Gita or some form, Bhagavatam, Isopanishad. Something you have read, isn't it? Have you read anyone? Can raise your hand whose books you have completed? Okay, very good. Thank you.
This time I'm reading Sanskrit too. So it's been 10 years. I read the Bhagavad Gita 5 times that time. And now I'm reading it again. So I've read Bhagavad Gita. And Srimad Bhagavatam to the 5th canto.
Okay. Very good. Thank you. Anybody else? Nobody has completed any particular book? Samro Prabhu? Still reading Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. So we are doing swadhyaya is going on. So everybody has doing their own self-enlightened ways, self-study. You know, we can say study group. In college, we gone study groups for reading, discussing more. So those things are there. Then jnana yajnas. So similarly, we wanted to obtain particular form of knowledge or religion. And in this way, these are the yoga systems which has been defined in order to understand the religious principles of our life. So now consider the religious principles of life when you want a discussion. We want to know what is irreligion. Suppose if I say, what is a good behavior, then my son say, can you explain what is a bad behavior? First, it's two sides of these things. What is a bad behavior? When it defined, then you can say, I am not. Then subsequently you are, yes, you are good behaved then. So what is a bad behavior? You have to discuss that. So we have to understand what is a bad religion or what is irreligion means. Then only we know what is good religion or what is real religion. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, it describes there are 5 types of irreligion which Prahlad Maharaj is giving. After approaching Narsingadev, Yudhishthir Maharaj was been asked by Narad Muni, and Narad Muni is explaining to Yudhishthir Maharaj about this whole thing. So go to text 15 first, Prabhuji, then we'll... 7, 15, 15. Okay. So, dharmartham api neheta, yatrartham badhano dhanam, anihani manashaya, mahair eva vrittida. Can you go to the translation? No, not this one actually. Maybe the 14 one, I think. Go back, or 12 or something. Go. Yes, so it is, which sloka it is? 14? Go to 12 and 13 maybe. Okay, can you go down? Yes. Sorry. So there are, no, just read the translation. Okay, thank you. There are five branches of irreligion, appropriately known as irreligion, vidharma, religious principles for which one is unfit, paradharma, pretentious religion, abhasa, analogical religion, upadharma, and cheating religion, chaladharma. One who is aware of real religion life must abandon these five as irreligion. So why this five thing is very important for neophyte devotees? Why? Because sometimes we consider this to be real religion. I will start from the backward, which is chaladharma. What is a chaladharma means? Suppose I give a Bhagavad Gita to you, written by somebody else, like what jugglery, which is not given the real meaning of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita, as per the books, as per the definitions of by Lord Krishna. Are you going to accept it? You can accept it, because if you are unaware of, you can accept it. So chaladharma is the one which is interpretations of the real truth into such a way that you completely are misled and you are completely taking into a different conclusion. Did you get it? Who didn't get it? Everybody got it? Can I ask you? Somebody can explain me that what chaladharma means.
Prabhu, chaladharma to mean is especially the real example life, especially in India, there are many so-called preachers who claims to be a god or incarnation of God, and they believe they are just telling that I am the God, and they are cheating the people. So to me, they are misrepresenting the facts, and they are, you know, for the innocent people, they are innocent people doesn't have any understanding about real knowledge which comes through the parampara, and they are just being cheated.
So there are many characteristics. So you are just combining all. So chaladharma especially is interpretation or jugglery words used to cover up the real stuffs of a particular scripture and give a mundane thing, not declaring yourself as God. Just like somebody is writing Srimad Bhagavad Gita on his own whims. He is not saying I am God, but he is not proving Krishna as God. So that is chaladharma. Chaladharma means you are likely chal. You are cheating. You are not saying that I am God or I know God. You are neither saying that I know God nor you are saying that I am God. But you are writing in a way that you are not even telling who is God, because you do not know yourself. You are not even telling. In Bhagavad Gita, if Krishna says sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam braja, he can say, no, he can, it is not Krishna you have to surrender, it is somebody else. Or he can interpret in his own way. That is particularly chaladharma. Those things you are declaring yourself God openly, that's vidharma. That's the part which is called the vidharma. So both are as contagious as the people. So the chaladharma is more detrimental, progress is checked to the intellectual people because they are stopped by the chaladharma. Every person has to come to these five stages of irreligion. Yes. Use microphone. Prabhuji has some questions. Use it.
So the Sanskrit word chala means trickery in Sanskrit. So which means that anybody who does any kind of trickery based on words, misinterpreting, it could be representing in a wrong way, anything that comes under chala dharma, right? That's what I thought.
Yes, exactly. So which is trickery, as Prabhuji mentioned, anything. Just Prabhupada mentioned about words jugglery and giving mundane interpretations of the real meaning of the Bhagavad Gita or many other scriptures. So these are all chala dharma. So similarly, there are many things which is defined in Srimad Bhagavatam, and especially we should know about those five. Let's read a little bit of the purport. Can you scroll down, Prabhuji? Okay. Let me read it. Any religious principles opposed to the principle of surrendering to the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality Godhead Krishna are to be considered religious principles of irregularity or cheating. And one who is actually interested in religion must give them up. One should simply follow the instructions of Krishna and surrender unto him. To do this, of course, one needs very good intelligence, which may be awakened after many, many births through good association with devotees and the practice of Krishna consciousness. Everything but the principle of religion recommended by Krishna, sarvadharman parityajyam mamaika saranam braja, should be given up as irreligion. So anybody who is saying something, so it's likely vidharma. Go to the translation, Prabhuji, again. So here, if you see, the vidharmi, or people say paradharma. Paradharma means parodharma bhaya bhaya. What does it mean? What does it mean? Can somebody tell? Yes.
Para means transcendental in Bhagavad Gita. And dharma is religion. So when you say paradharma, parodharma, what was the second word? Bhayabhayo means it gets rid of all fear, the worst kind of dangerous fear in life. You resolve yourself of that fear, which is, I don't know what, it's the fear of death, I guess. And you resolve and you get rid of that fear if you follow this dharma of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Okay, thank you. So here he talks about, that is paro and apara, which is different. This is about talking about just like substitute, subset, upadharma, like this. So these are different. It is constitution of an irreligion. Okay. So this vidharma, paradharma, upadharma, and chaladharma, these are these five things, which is one can go like pretentious religions, like abhas. Pretentious religions means most people go and, oh, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there in Mayapur. He was discussing about Sankirtan and most transcendental topic. That time, some hundreds of people are running. He saw that in the street, hundreds of people are running from one side to another. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked, what's happening? Why they are going? Where are they going? And why they are going? So he just asked one of his associates, so he said, go and check. So he went and checked with them. Where are you going? No, don't stop. What happened? No, in Ganga, in the center, God appeared. Somebody said that there is a boat and it is becoming like sticks. It is dwindling and moving to and fro. And we all are running there because somebody said that God has appeared there. He came and informed Lord Chaitanya Ji. They are running to see God in the middle of the Ganga because God appeared. Mahaprabhu said, God is not so cheap. He would appear to and fro anywhere and everywhere. It's like abhas. We wanted to know about God. We all wanted to see God. And we run after something. Hey, I've seen God. I'll show you God. I will do this one. Because we have this same mentality to see God in our own gross form without performing anything. Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, Lord Narad Muni, when he is telling how he became Narad Muni. So when he was a 5-year-old boy by a maid servant, then he served the Paramahansa Bhaktivedantis for 4 months, washing their utensils, washing their, whenever their food, cleaning their stuffs, and eating, after asking them, taking permission, eating their remnants. He served them 4 months. And after that, his mother was dead by snake bite. She is no more other than anyone else. She was completely dependent on Supreme Lord. She was walking forests, hills, rivers, mountains, peaks, agriculture, land, cities, and everyone. Then finally he was completely frustrated and meditating on the Supreme Lord. Lord appeared just for the second. He said, "You are not yet qualified to see me, behold me for a long time." At that time, he has served so many years. Narada Muni, Lord said that you are not qualified to see me, hold my this beautiful vision for a long time. But he told him that you will become Narad and you will preach my glories. Now, after when he became Narada Muni, in this next birth from Brahma, when he appeared, he is able to withhold, which is able to hold the vision in his heart. He carries Lord Narayan all the time. He can see him. But at the time when he saw first time, momentarily Lord gives him darshan. But he said that he cannot. Where is the Lord gone? I don't see him now. Then the Lord gave a divine voice. You are not qualified to see me further. Go there. How can those people doing nothing? We are getting up at 10 o'clock, not taking bath for 4 days. Somebody says that God is appearing there, and is God appearing there? We have to see God by our austerity. We have to see God by our transcendental knowledge. We have to see God by our sacrifice, by our chanting, constantly, constant endeavor of chanting. What we read of the Brahma Samhita, text 59, says the three things, constant endeavor by scriptural evidence. Right? The scriptural evidence is the number one. That is very important. The scriptural evidence has to be there. So in this same section, what is talking about is Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when he said that he cannot see. So my point here, I wanted to say the abhas. Everybody wants to see, so they follow some form of irreligion, some form of persons, just like Rajesh Prabhu mentioned in the earlier one, that somebody is declaring, I am God. Because we want to see who is doing something superior than me, we consider him as God or Goddess. I am not able to perform some magic. I know my child is lying dead. If somebody comes at the time and sees, saves my thing, oh, you are like God. He's like acting as a, all doctors are God? No, their doctors are human. All engineers are God, they're all humans. All are human with certain intelligence level. You may be a little fool, he may be a little intelligent, you may be a little intelligent, that may be. So all the things are varied. Intelligence is there in the human society. That doesn't mean that one is qualified to become God or became God or already a God. So these five things, the vidharma, upadharma, paradharma, chaladharma, and these things, what are the things? Five, vidharma, then paradharma, abhas, and upadharma. Analogical religion. So all the things, go to the next sloka, Prabhuji, the text 13. So what is that? 12, right? Go to 13. Okay. So here, what is, it's some explanation is given. Scroll down the translation. Let's read the translation. So religious principles that obstruct one from following his own religion are called vidharma. You got it? Religious principles that obstruct one from following his own religion are called vidharma. Religious principles introduced by others are called paradharma. Okay? A new type of religion created by one who is falsely proud and who opposes the principles of the Veda is called upadharma. An interpretation by one's jugglery of words is called chaladharma. So one has to know. Because if you know this vidharmis, the adharmis, the chaladharmis, the paradharmis, then you will know what exactly the real religion means. What exactly the... Even though if you are... You have to diagnose when you go for book distribution, when you go for preaching. We have seen many gods. People are worshipping many different varieties. Hundreds of people we meet, they are having 100 different gods. Without understanding, without really following the dharmam to sakshat bhagavat pranitam. In Bhagavatam it is says, dharmam, what is the real meaning of dharmam? Dharmam to sakshat bhagavat pranitam. What is that? Means one has to surrender unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is real religion. other than that is not real religion. So the Vidharmis and those people who has to be known by the one, just like Prabhupada says in a different context when he was talking about in Vrindavan, the temple is being built. So generally, the Indians, those people who cheat, right, to the, our devotees, especially to the American devotees, they see, they cheat in the financially, oh, we did this, the money is gone. But Prabhupada say, I am a Calcutta man, Bengali man. I am a Bengali man, I can cheat the newer guys. So that's what I am safe. He protected in many years by his intelligence, by his interference in the situations which is very tough. He really saved his disciples to be cheated. Because one time in that Vrindavan, they are putting the marbles and all. And Prabhupada came and saw, what is this? He said, this is the guy said that they put a new pattern, some portion. A new pattern was there. This is a new pattern. Prabhupada says, rascal. Well, why? It is not a new pattern. He is just cheating you. How? He has put bad stone and he's just putting his new pattern. Some bad stone. They want to cover up. So, you know, it's like this rectangle. Now it's becoming diamond shape or diagonal shape. So it's a new pattern. No, it's not a new pattern. So they are arguing, no, it's a new pattern. Is it? Because he's covering up his own fault and because you are innocent, so he's cheating you. So you have to identify, you have to detect it. In the day-to-day activities also, you have to detect those kind of things. But it is for the Krishna. So many times, such of this transcendental the behavior of Srila Prabhupada, transcendental pastimes of Srila Prabhupada, which teaches us that how we can know about the intricacies of the Supreme Lord's behavior. So similarly, Prabhupada always mentions, even though if you can go and read each line to line, analyze the meanings and go deeper into each of these five religious principles, still you will be cheated if you are not surrendered to the real religion. Isn't it? Sometimes you appear sentimental religion, abhas. This abhas is likely more sentimental religion. I love this particular person, she's so great, she's so divine. I'm getting cheated by her. Somebody who is no implicit faith unto Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, cannot give you the mercy, Krishna consciousness, cannot give you the bhakti. No matter where she belongs, no matter where he belongs, where she belongs, or whatever actions he may be, but you cannot get the ultimate result of your life, which is bhakti. It is impossible. It is impossible to get the bhakti without the mercy of an unalloyed pure devotee of the Supreme Lord. Have you read that in Srimad Bhagavad Gita? Prabhuji, Bhagavad Gita, that 428, please go back again. Go to the last section. Yes, that's fine. All the yogis are faithfully engaged in different types of sacrifice and are seeking a higher status of life. Krishna consciousness, however, is different from these because it is the direct service of the Supreme Lord. Krishna consciousness cannot be attained by any one of the above mentioned types of sacrifice, but can be attained only by the mercy of the Lord and his bona fide devotees. Yasya prasadat bhagavat prasad, yasya prasadanna gati kutopi. Because without the mercy of the Supreme Lord, you cannot get the real bhakti. And many times you can see, because Krishna consciousness, this is transcendental. You can go ahead. Now at least we have to, all the devotees, even the neophyte stage, you have to know the basic of the five stages of irreligion things. That's what you can counterattack them. Why it is not real religion? Because you can quote 7.15.15. Can you remember this? Sat pandra pandra. 7.15.15. Everybody can remember? 7.15.15 talks about five things. Very simple. What is those five things? Basically 7.15.12.13.14.15, but I am just remember to closer to that. Which talks about this thing, 7, 15, 12, 13, 14, 15. He talks about this five irreligion. Who can say the five irreligion? name. Other than Radha Prabhu, he is more intelligent now. Salva Prabhuji. Take, use the microphone, please give.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes.
Vidharma, Paradharma, Ubadharma, Abhasa, Chaladharma.
Very good. Give a big hand to Prabhuji. Is it difficult? Who did not get it? Everybody got it? Tell one example of Chaladharma. Salva Prabhuji, tell one example of Chaladharma.
Chaladharma is writing without authority, writing the wrong statement and saying that Krishna is Vishnu is, or Krishna is not the God, or not directly saying that what it is.
Concocting, so, misguiding, yes, misinterpreting.
Misguiding.
Exactly. Thank you. So these are the things, at least in one of this form, if you know, then we found what is the real dharma? Real dharma is dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. What is real dharma? Dharma means to surrender unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Surrender unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Why don't people surrender? Which is very interesting things. We can say the people, why don't people surrender to Krishna and why people surrender to Krishna? So there is one example which is given. I was telling to few kids, my kids and those Aprameya and Anameya, there's four of them, I was telling them a story. So I'm repeating here to all of you. So how Lord Krishna is bhaktavatsala and merciful, and why people don't surrender, and why a bird, a simple bird, surrendered to Krishna and get the mercy. Everybody knows about Mahabharata war. 18 days Mahabharata war took place where? Kurukshetra in India. How many days? 18 days. So the first day, all has to come to the Kurukshetra, right? They are staying nearby camp. So in the morning, the Mahabharata has to start. So when the sun rises, they all came to the spot. When they are coming, coming with what? Bike or car? No. They are coming with the chariot, like horses, elephants, with their walking men, the walking soldiers, especially the horses and the elephants. That's the age. Now the age of motor vehicles, cars, bulldozer, trucks, big, big trucks, SUVs. But they are coming with the chariots. When they are coming on the path, so a titiri bird, a small bird, you know, like sparrow, not a sparrow, but titiri, similar kind of bird, who has laid eggs that day? Where? In the Kurukshetra war which happened. When she heard the sound of these elephants and the horses trembling, dun, 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 like that which is coming up, tup, 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 tup. Human being, you can be scared, isn't it? You can be scared by such a tumultuous sound. The bird was scared. He said, what is going to happen? But because that time, the whole world was auspicious. Everybody, even the demons know that God, Krishna is God. He is some superior power. They don't surrender, which is a different thing. But the bird also knows, by the mercy of Lord, animals, birds, everybody knows Krishna is the Lad. And the bird, because in the Dwapara Yuga, at the time of the Kurukshetra war, by the mercy of the Lord, he knows, not only that bird, every animals, they know Krishna is his Lord. And she prayed, oh my Lord Krishna, please save my four eggs. I am flying to get food, somehow please save it. And she flew away, because she has to protect her life, the eggs are there. When the Yuddha is coming, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan Krishna said, right, that I protect my devotees. What he said? Ma sucha, do not fear. All the side of Pandavas are not afraid, because Krishna is towards Arjuna. He said, do not fear, ma sucha. Why I have to be afraid of that? He's not afraid. The bird is also not afraid. And Krishna, because he is the super soul, he is Swarad, he is Avijna, he is Paramatma, he is in your heart, his heart, everybody's heart. He is in everybody's atom. He understands your prayers within your heart and within the Golaka also. Golaka eva nikhasalti akhilatma bhuta. He is there in the Golaka, but still he is spread out all across this universe. He remembered the prayers of the bird. So after this Bhagavad Gita spoken for an hour, then what Krishna said? Krishna said to Arjun, Arjun, what you said to me? Karishye vachanam tava. I will do as you ask me. No question asked. I ask you, do it, do it. If I ask you, Radha Kripa Prabhu, get a glass of water, throw there. Get a glass of water, throw there. 7 times I can say, no question asked. Because you said, whatever you say tonight, you will do for me. That's it. So similarly, Krishna, Arjun said, whatever you ask for me, I will do for you. And what he did? Krishna said, take your Gandiv, shoot that arrow to the horse, to the elephant, where he is wearing a bell. You know, bell? Tin, 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 tin. Have you seen the cow has a bell? So similarly, the elephant, because all the elephants are decorated, the war. That weight of that bell is 1 ton. Just imagine how ton will be the weight of that elephant is. Weight of that bell is 1 ton. Shoot that arrow to that bell. Arjun said, Karishye vachanam tava. I won't ask you any questions. Just shoot the arrow. What? Tell me what to do. Shoot the arrow to the elephant's bell. Arjun was thinking, why is he asking this? Shoot the arrow to the elephant's bell. So anyway, he took that arrow, shoot that arrow to the elephant's bell. Arjuna is particular. If he shoots, take the nail out from the elephant, the, only the nail of the middle finger will go out. Isn't it? Do you agree? Do you agree the capability of Arjun?
Yes.
All agree. There is no doubt about it. He shoot means without touching, without taking an inch of blood, without touching the even skin of the elephant, the bell fell down. Trum! And that bell fell down in such a way that it protected the 4 eggs. It was there, nearby. So it crumbles like this, and it came to the middle, one section, and it protected, because the bell has hollow inside, right? So it fell into such a way that it completely covers this one, and it generates a temperature which is suitable for the egg to grow. That's why the mother lays eggs, have you seen? Mother lays eggs because they produce a kind of a temperature in order to the bird to come out from the egg. Have you seen anyone, real egg to real chicken to come out? No, maybe closer. But that's the one, when you put it, that is going on. The bird came in the evening. He saw no egg. He was crying. He was looking around, foraging around, again praying to God, again going back. After 18 days, one day, one horse was going, and it just touches the top of the bell, and it fell. So the bell was open, just likely 4:35 p.m. in the evening. 5 p.m. the war has to end. Then the bird came in the same evening. When she saw that the 4 bird is coming out of this bell, oh my God, how can the mother cannot recognize her own son? Is it untrue? Any mother in the world can recognize their own son, isn't it? Either in the big hospital or in their home or anywhere else. Either human beings or a cow or a bird, they can recognize their own son. When she saw the 4 birds are coming out from this, she prayed to Lord Krishna, Jaya Shri Krishna, Jaya Shri Krishna, Jaya Shri Krishna. When she chanted, Lord reciprocated through his heart. She took and flew away. So if you all pray to God, each living being, he is going to protect you. How? It is up to him. When? It is up to him. But the mercy is due to all of you. The protection is already guaranteed by the sincere prayer of the devotees, undoubtedly. No doubt. So do not fear. Always sincerely pray to the Supreme Lord. It won't go in vain. It won't go in vain, either in pleasure or in pain. He is the protector. He is the Bhakta Vatsal. He can protect a simple bird in the whole 640 million soldiers are killed. 4 birds he has protected. If any of the soldiers could have prayed sincerely to Krishna, protect me, he could have protected. But none of them has prayed there. We come here, we are Kshatriyas. We come here to fight, we'll die. Well, you desired so. I bless you so. You desired so, I bless you so. If you think I am my own comfort level, I am an IT man, I will die in front of the computer, you're blessing so. Who is stopping you? God blessing you all. His blessing is there. But if you say, I die in front of you, my Lord, by seeing you like Bhishma, blessing so. You be so. Because your prayer is there. So Lord Krishna is very, very merciful. Because his bhaktavatsala, all the yoga you saw is incomparably significant, insignificant in terms of the little prayer of the bard. So we have to follow, we have to make him a guru. How the bard has prayed to Sri Krishna and get the mercy. So we have to pray to Lord Krishna. So how to get, why we don't pray? Because we have the anger, lust, greed. Those six elements. So today, in the second half, we'll be talking about those eight coverings. Have you heard about Ashtadhatu? Who knows about Ashtadhatu? You don't know? Ashtadhatu Murti, Ashtadhatu, we do like, anybody can tell? Nobody knows? Yeah. Give microphone to Rajesh Prabhu. Please take some prasadam, those who are living. We have some prasadam, please take on the back. Can you help someone? Samara Prabhu, give them some prasadam, they are living, if they are.
It's metal made of, you know, eight different types of basically minerals, right? You know?
Yes.
Different metals type.
Yes, so this special metals becomes it more spiritual, like you have brass, you have iron, you have silver, you have gold, you have copper. Aluminium. So there are eight elements which makes it more complete to make the deities of the Lord. Just like you see the small deities which is made of those eight elements. Those eight elements becomes more auspicious to worship. So similarly, we have also those processes. What is those? Let me to go to the 22 Prabhuji now. 7:15:22. Okay. Many times we, so before I go, is there anyone has any questions on the online? Any comments or any questions? Prabhuji, any text message or anything? Okay, you are getting the. Or any viewers has any comments they can also give. Anybody has, anybody likes to share or comments anything, whatever we have discussed so far? Okay, then we can proceed. So, this text 22 and 23, which talks about how we come to the stage of sincere prayer to God. How we perform the bhakti yoga. We learn about drabya yoga. We learn about Swadhyaya Yajna. We learn about many other yajnas, yoga yajnas, jnana yajnas, right? So how we can learn about the Sankirtan Yajna? The Sankirtan Yajna is this the real yoga of this age of Kali. How we learn about the Sankirtan Yajna? So what is there? Let me read this 22 and 23. Go to the translation. Okay. We all know problems, I will give you the solution, okay? For all of you, you will get eight solutions today. First one is, by making plans with determination, one should give up lusty desires for sense gratification. Similarly, by giving up envy, one should conquer anger. By discussing the disadvantages of accumulating wealth, one should give up greed. And by discussing the truth, one should give up fear. Go to 23. Translation. Okay. By discussing spiritual knowledge, one can conquer lamentation and illusion. By serving a great devotee, one can become prideless. By keeping silent, one can avoid obstacles on the path of mystic yoga. And by stopping sense gratification, one can conquer envy. So, kama esa, krodha esa. These are the things which is culmination of the rajaguna. Rajaguna samudbhava, right? Kama esa, krodha esa. These things, lust, anger and greed, out of them, greed is more dangerous. Greed is more violent and it can attack you. And anger is very difficult to control. So here is the solution in this. This is called Ashtadhatu, means it is a circle. It starts with envy, it ends with envy. Did you follow? How you are controlling the envy? If you give up your envy, envy means you are envious towards someone, by renouncing enviousness towards your colleagues, towards your neighbor, towards someone else, let's say, what you will get? You will win anger. Did you follow? Let's keep in your mind. We'll come back to that. By renouncing enviousness, what I am going to get? I can master our anger. By discussing how we accumulate bad wealth, let's say some corrupted people, here you may not find in India, there are corrupted people, they're going to jail, somebody is killed by someone in shooting, some wealthy man. You discuss those demerits of accumulating so much of wealth, then you won't be overcome by greed, isn't it? Suppose if you see, he has cheated. In earlier days, at least 150 years ago, in Kashmir, if somebody steals money, then his hand is cut. No argument. If he is found guilty, his hand is cut. By hearing this, can a thief go and steal? That mentality, oh, no, 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 I want to save my hand. I don't want to go. Because heavy penalty is there. So that's why they don't do it. Similarly, if you discuss how they are accumulating wealth by corrupt means, by this one, by that one, do you want to follow that? He has cheated, he has gone to jail 5 times, he is in hospital, he is in jail, he's many times, so I don't need that wealth. Do you want that kind of wealth? Do you want, any of you? We want peace. We want happy. So by discussing that, if there is a greed within your mind, within your heart, to accumulate more wealth by wrong means, that will be vanquished. That doesn't mean that you should not acquire wealth. You should acquire wealth in a nice way, in an honest means, what is prescribed for you. But those things will be gone. Now, discussing about what? Truth. You can conquer fear. How do you conquer fear? What is truth then? Discussing about truth means today I discuss about truth. The truth is I am not a body. The truth is I am a spirit soul. I discuss in that line. The truth is that I am a spirit soul. I am an eternal servant of Krishna. I want to discuss that Krishna has 8 principal wives. That is the absolute truth. I wanted to discuss that Krishna was born from Vasudeva and Devaki. I want to desire all truth. If you think that 101 freeway has 4 lanes, is that truth? That's also truth, isn't it? That's also truth. But tomorrow that can be 5 lanes. After that, there may be 7 lanes. Or after a few years, after El Nino, there may be 2 lanes. Who knows, isn't it? But what is the value of that thing? You have to know what is the reality, what is the absolute truth. We are not talking about relative truth. We are talking about absolute truth. Discuss absolute truth, fear will go away. Very beautiful example, few devotees from Russia. They are going to where? They are going to Badrikashram for the pilgrimage. Have you been Badrikashram? Very top of the mountain, Himalayas. Bir Krishna Prabhu, have you been there? Not yet. So, very beautiful place. So, when they are going in a bus, middle of the way, somehow the bus turned to the one side of this mountain. So, one turn, everybody was screaming, "Wow!" Just imagine, from the mountain, it's not like that. From Yosemite top of these things, if your car slips, what is happening? "Wow!" We are going to scream, isn't it? So, they are screaming. But out of one of them, is a pure devotee was situated. Within that screaming, he or she, I don't know, she said, "Please chant. This is the time to chant Hare Krishna." Yeah. They chanted, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I'm not talking a story, it is a reality. It's a real thing. Happened at least 10, 15 years ago, which is from someone's own experience he's sharing. They chanted it mystically, unbelievably. Krishna is the protector, we saw, right? He can save the bird. Why not he can save the humans? 2, 3, 4 round, it got hit into a big tree. The bus stopped there. Hare Krishna. 4 times Hare Krishna, the bus stopped into the, hitting a big tree. They go into the valley from there. Just see, it's like 10,000 feet. Such a big height. Not even Lake Tahoe. It's from heavenly to joining to the Lake Tahoe. Not that, it's so huge. Drift there. They stopped it. They came out from there. They touched the feet of the person who encouraged them. We all know that. But at that time, it's not coming up. It's not coming up. So we have to advance. We have to mature our mind. So at that time, it will come up. Or you have to be association with such an exalted devotee. Then you will be saved, isn't it? Because of that person, all of the devotees, all of them are devotees. But one has to spark the light. Because of the presence of that person, they all are saved. And by how do you fear? Discussing the truth. At that time, what is the reality? That I am going to die, that is the truth. You are going to take birth again. Jatasya hi dhruva mrityur. That is the one you have to discuss. You are going to do it. But those discussion of truth doesn't come when we are in great distress. But you should remember, when discussing the truth, one will give up fear. Agree? Go to the 23 approach. By discussing spiritual knowledge, one can conquer lamentation and illusion. Who is not lamenting? I lost my stocks today, I would have gone it, my Baba is gone, my Facebook stock is gone, my this, Google, I spent this. Where is that lamentation and jubilation? Everybody is doing some level of lamentation, isn't it? You are lamenting? Oh, I am a real estate business, that guy didn't buy from me. I am this guy, I would have bought that house, it's now $1 million. I made such mistakes. All things can happen, guys, in the world. Nothing is accidental. You don't deserve it. Simple thing. Simple thing. It is not accidentally. I would have been now, I have been IS officer, I have been president of India. Come on, stop it. There is nothing accident in the world. Your karma is destined for you to suffer or to enjoy or to go there or go there. You work like an ass. You won't be a millionaire. Why are you working? Better work for Krishna, isn't it? I am going to get what I am destined to get it. Either you put extra efforts or low effort or more efforts. So there is no point of lamentation. If something comes lamentation in your mind, the solution is discuss spiritual knowledge. By discussing spiritual knowledge, if you are in illusion, if you are in lamentation, you will overcome it. Everybody has lamentation in the life. Some form. Because if you are not pure devotees, we are not. So we will have some level of lamentation. But God is giving solution here. Prahlad Maharaj, Yudhishthira, Narad Muni is giving solutions to Yudhishthira Maharaj. That after finishing the war, he was in lamentation. What you have to do? Discuss spiritual knowledge. What is the spiritual knowledge? Open Bhagavad Gita, open Bhagavatam, open Chaitanya Charitamrita, read a prayer, chant Hare Krishna, come to the temple, donate to the temple, do something, my dear friend. Discuss spiritual knowledge. And if you are proudy man, do you have a proudy man? Anyone? Who? You are a proudy man. One person at least, honest man. He says, so what you can do? By serving a great devotee, one can become prideless. Isn't it a fact? By serving a great devotee, first of all, where do you find a great devotee? We have a great devotee here. Srila Prabhupada is there. Is he not a great devotee? He is the purest devotee. He is here. By serving him means offering obeisances, bringing flowers, fruits, money, whatever you have, good intentions, good thought, good saying, distribute books for him. Any simple thing we do for Prabhupada is service. Because I remember when Prabhupada is there in Newark, the first temple, what he did? He was giving the Bhagavad Gita discourse. At the time, a crazy man, you know, just like street beggars, crazy man came inside the room. Everybody was looking at him. He didn't talk to anyone. He simply went to the toilet. He cleaned it. He put a new the tissue paper. When he came out, they all saw it. Prabhupada said, that is service. Simple beggar, he cannot talk, he didn't attend the class, but he performed service to Prabhupada's movement. They're glorified. Glorified by such a great acharya, by a simple service, such a menial service. Can you believe that? Like Titira Bard, who is praying to Krishna, and he was protected by Lord Krishna, within the 640 millions of soldiers was killed. So simply, that person was praised, glorified by Srila Prabhupada, simply by doing some service. Can't we do that? We can buy tissue paper. How many dollars, Prabhuji? $51 to month. Monthly donation, you give $51, we buy all the tissue paper in the room for all our three bathrooms. Are you ready to serve something?
Yes.
Yes, we all can serve so that it is for your benefit. What you are going to get it? You'll be pride more or less? Less. You will be prideless by serving a great devotee. This is not my solution. Narad Muni's direct instruction he is giving, so we should follow it. Next one is, by keeping silent, one can avoid obstacles on the path of mystic yoga. Keeping silent means, I talk too much today, isn't it? But this is silence itself. By talking about Krishna, by discussing, is itself a silence. Prabhupada never encouraged us to be unnecessarily silent without opening the mouth. We have to open mouth for Krishna all the time. If you are chanting Bhagavad Gita throughout the day, that is also a silence. Silence means if you are talking too much, of 49ers win or who wins, Warriors won or somebody else won, or this won or that. These are all mundane talks. This is, we have to silence our mind. That guys, you talked enough. Now open Bhagavad Gita. Open spiritual topics. So silence means talking about Krishna is itself silence. Because that's what we are silencing our mind. Think that you guys are all bad weather. In Christmas, New Year, happy holidays, everybody is enjoying somewhere else. You are here, celebrating with Krishna, isn't it? So that is itself a great merit. So what you do is, by being silent, one can avoid obstacles on the path of mystic yoga. You got it? And the last one is, and simply by stopping sense gratification, one can conquer envy. How do you conquer envy? Sense gratification. So Prabhupada, one time someone is asking, why do you say that you are envious towards animals, that's what we are killing? So is it logical? I am envious towards cow, so I am killing? But yes, we are envious towards cow, that's what we are killing. We are envious towards other living beings, that's what we are torturing them. We are thinking superior. I am jealous towards them because she's giving milk, she's so proteinous, so nutrients. So how does, very important point, sense gratification. Because my tongue is desiring to eat beef, that's what I am killing the cows. My tongue is desiring to taste the wine, that's what I am going for all filthy places. My tongue is desiring to eat such thing like that. So this is the things one should know, I call it Ashtadhatu. Did you get it, Ashtadhatu? The Ashtadhatu is stopping here. How many we got it? Which is connecting again to envy. So who can know that by giving up envy, what you get? Very good. Very memorable. High memory. By giving up envy, we win anger. And how do you overcome envy? Stopping sense gratification. And how do you overcome greed? By discussing the bad things, how people acquire wealth, right? You see that, oh, he went to jail by winning, by going to the corruption, he got bribery from 5%, but he went to jail. By this one, the man terrorist sued him because he owned so much of money. If you are, oh, he got lottery, $5 million, but after 5 months, he is beggar. He lost his job even. Because all neighbors, friends, everybody called him, oh, now party time, we are now big man, everybody is praising. When the money is gone, honey is gone. Isn't it? Money is there, honey is there. After that, so that's the theory of the rule. So we have to be, we want what? I want both money and honey. Then who is that? You have to serve Krishna. Your money and honey is well protected by serving Krishna. So then discussing truth, what you get? Give up? Fear. So what is the truth we talked about? 3A101 has four lengths. Is that the truth? Absolute truth, not relative truth. We're discussing about absolute truth, that Krishna is the Supreme Personality, Godhead. I want to discuss today about Naranara and Rishi. I want to discuss about Kapil Muni, who is the son of Mother Devahuti and Kardab Muni. I wanted to discuss about Parshuram, how he killed 21 times the Kshatriyas. I wanted to discuss about Lord Ram, how he killed the Dasanan. These are the absolute truth. By discussing this, what you can do? You overcome the fear. You overcome the fear because when we are in, few days ago we went to Lake Tahoe to see the snows. So it was so much of snows, my kids are scared. I said, you have to chant 108 times nursing prayer. Then we are safe. Because big avalanche in Highway 50 and the whole vehicles are stopped for like 2 hours, more than almost 2 hours. And neither you can go backward nor we can go forward. And in which hour it's like snow is covering almost 2-3 feet my car. I said, we have to go ahead. So there is no way and there is no food. By the way, we are lost. We finished all our whatever we have taken. So very little to go. But anyway, by chanting nursing prayer, not 108, but reaching to that point, nursing day was merciful before that. So that's the one. But the point is, we always have to be prayer, sincere prayers, either in a good way, good terms, in a bad terms, in a good position, in a bad position, we have to depend on Krishna's mercy. So what he's doing? And by discussing spiritual knowledge, one can conquer lamentation and illusion. So today, are you chanting, Ravak? No more chanting we are. We're not chanting now? Okay. So what do you want me to stop? Do the kirtan, huh? Okay, that's fine. So, okay, we have 10 more minutes, so I will just end up take some reflection. So by discussing spiritual knowledge, one can conquer lamentation and illusion. So if everybody has lamentation is there, as I discussed, so you can overcome by discussing spiritual knowledge. By serving a great devotee, one can become prideless. Serving a great devotee means by joining, as a Damodar said, by a monthly donor. Being as a monthly donor, you become prideless because it is continuously going on. So you can start with serving, just like I mentioned, Srila Prabhupada did tissue paper, which just comes $31, which can serve 3 bathrooms. $10, $10, $10. $1 extra. Isn't it? $31. We just serve. At least we can do something, isn't it? Is it a big thing? Let's make the new year. 2016, I give $31 to Krishna every month. Not a big thing. I do many things, but no excuse. You just start with that. If you can, we can do for my son. If you have 2 kids, you can just do $10 each, 10, 10 each. So everybody can do something. So by doing that, it is for your benefit. You will be prideless. And by keeping silent, one can avoid obstacles on the path of mystic yoga. Which is mystic yoga, the bhakti yoga is also mystic yoga. So too many discussion about the mundane things. Or many other mundane things. There are many mundane things going on. I don't believe that how much people have time, because when I go to work, they talk about so many things. I said, how do you get time? The football, they talk about baseball, the basketball, I don't know any kind of games which is coming up and what not. Elections. Huh? Elections. Elections is coming up. Prabhuji is after election, man. That's coming up. So many things, basically. But they are getting time to talk about, discuss about that. But at least by listening them, we get something out of it. So why I have to waste my time? So that's thing. So we should not unnecessarily endeavor too much. But something is coming up for your own benefit, you can do it. And then the last one is, no, go to 23, Prabhuji. We are discussing 23. Yes, thank you. So, last one is, simply by stopping sense gratification, one conquer envy. This is my Ashtadhatu. It starts with envy, anger, greed, fear, lamentation and illusion, prideless, and obstacles remover. Then again you come to envy. Ashtadhatu. Just like Ashtadhatu worshipable. This Ashtadhatu is everything. Earlier we used to know the problem. But each problem is dependent on triggered with a solution. Suppose today I ask now 5 minutes, question mark. Please stop this one, go to the other part. Prabhuji, go to Bhagavad Gita 428. So now the question is, two questions I will ask. Anybody can. How do we give up fear? So microphone is there. Very simple. What do you get? I need to know.
Okay.
No, you have to raise hand. I wanted to see how many raise hand. Okay. What did you say? Say in the microphone, because those who are in the internet may not know. How do you overcome fear?
Acquiring the truth, Prabhuji.
Very good. So discussing about the absolute truth. Okay. Now the next question is, how do you become prideless? Raise your hand. Okay, here. So everybody gets a chance. Give it. Tell your name and...
Shubhankar Krishnadas, serving the pure devotees.
Serving the pure devotees. Very good. Now third question is, how do you conquer envy? Victoria.
Give up sense gratification.
Excellent. Big hand. One person only. Sense gratification stopping. Then, how do you win anger? How do you control our anger? Okay. Shyamalangi Mataji.
Giving up the envy.
Very good. Giving up the envy. Big give a hand. Then last question is, how do you overcome lamentation and illusion? Lamentation and illusion. Okay. Hand behind. Give a microphone at the end. Give a microphone at the end. Tell your name and say the answer.
My name is Sridhar. By discussing scriptural knowledge.
Very good. By discussing scriptural. Please give a big hand to him. Sridhar Prabhu. Okay, and the last one maybe. Where is that one? Prideless we talk about. Okay, how do you advance in mystic yoga or bhakti yoga path? What techniques you do? Being silent. Exactly. So let me repeat it again so that it can, those who did not get it, one more time. By doing good plans for spiritual advancement, you give up lusty desires. Okay? You win the lusty desires if you have. That I wanted to win the hand of the beautiful woman. I plan for this. Then you make plans for Krishna. Then win the lusty desires. By giving up envy, you control anger. By discussing the bad things about acquiring wealth, you overcome greed. By discussing about absolute truth, you give up fear. By discussing about the spiritual knowledge, you can overcome lamentation and illusion. By serving a great devotee, by joining our monthly donor program, you become prideless. And by keeping silent, you advance in mystic yoga or bhakti yoga. And by stopping sense gratification, you conquer envy. This is our Ashtadhatu, the Ashta solution, 8 solution for this day today. Ashta Siddhi. If you get all those things and plan little bit in this one, then definitely you will get pure devotion to Supreme Lord. Any further questions? We have 1 more minute. Last questions from anyone? Okay, if not, then we'll end here. I would like to thank you very much. So we'll have Aartik now. Please stand up and assemble ladies this side, gents on the other side, and we'll do the kirtan. Hare Krishna. Thank you.